So back to the science-y of the zeros. So we have the Mayan construct. There they are, they're writing these numbers. And we're like, well, all of a sudden, the creation of it is almost like work to do. You see that? So as soon as there is that adamantation moment of, hey, look, there's something not completed. There's something not finished. There's something not done. There's work to do. So if we can take ourselves back, you know, 3,000 years ago, 6,000 years ago, behind that zero, let's get, you know, behind it, before the zero actually was put into writing again and again and again, and became like this major controller of governments and power all around the world. Take yourself back to when we were tribal, when we had little tiny tribes here, little tiny tribes there. There was not this big zero, what did you do today you didn't finish, to push around. You know, there wasn't that big boss syndrome. Now, with zero itself, it really compounded the boss syndrome. You didn't do this, you didn't do that, and then guess what? The zero itself has become larger. The zero itself has become, you have to put this into the basket of zero, and that into the basket, and this other thing into the basket. So you end up with, to actually complete a job. So let's say you had to go and head out to just go gather something. I'm just going to go gather, you know, wander with the flow and gather. That is no longer the key. You cannot do that. There is a task, a beginning, and an end, and if you don't do it, you're in trouble. Now, the reason you're in trouble is because there is a controller of the zero. There's a controller of the zero that it becomes the controller of the time that zero, that action that happens within that constructed time frame. Because somebody is now trying to control the people, the persons, within that time construct, within that work ethic or governmental brainwash, all of that going on within that zero time frame. So if you can put yourself back behind the zero, okay, just like way, way before zero even existed, as a controller. You know, just don't look at it as a controller. Just jump out of it, jump out of the basket of its demand. Because I think itself, you know, you look at, well, it's nothing, it looks like nothing. But when you actually, even if we can take it into like millions and trillions or whatever, take it into the numbers, and you start to see all of the people underneath that million, and with every little zero that gets attached to that number, how many people are controlled by the binds of that money, by the binds of those numbers. So yeah, it starts to be like the more zeros you attach, more control, power, sequence begins with, like I said, with governments and corporations and blah, 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 and you know, what is your job and how much money do you make, and you know, and so the controllers start to be the ones that have the extra zeros, you know, whether it's in their bank accounts or in their salaries. So they waltz this world as the controllers. So yeah, so unfortunately that's where we are. We're with people that are running around with these big fat zeros, and these zeros are they've used them as wedges, and they've waged wars against people because of that. We construct our time this way, and you're not constructing your time the same way as I construct my time, and I demand zeros to be constructed in this particular fashion, and you're just a zero according to me. You've just become a zero, and I control you because I have more zeros. So that's a short-sighted version of a person and of a self. But yeah, there's a lot of people walking the world that way. So yay, let's try to bring ourselves behind that overt control or self, and you might find you're a better human being in there. Inside your own fanaticism, over the zero schedule and ownership. Yay.